Riddler Revenge is a Vekoma Suspended Looping Coaster, for short, an SLC. If you've been around the coaster community for some time, you should know that Vekoma SLCs are among the most disliked coasters out there. Is the hate towards these looping coasters warranted? Well, in my review today, I hope to answer this question, at least when we're talking about Riddler Revenge at Six Flags New England. All right, let's get to the review. Presentation. At the beginning of the 2018 season, Mind Eraser was renamed and rethemed to Riddler Revenge. This was done so it would tie in with the whole Gotham City area of the park. The theming in this area of the park isn't that impressive, but it's Six Flags, so I wasn't expecting much. The theming on the ride is almost non-existent. Beyond the sign, there's really not much to pull you into the whole realm of the Riddler. The ride was nicely painted a green and yellow. The colors really pop and work very well. The trains also have gotten an upgrade with new color design and new vest restraints. It's nice to see that the park is trying to reinvigorate a less popular attraction, and with that said, I think Riddler gets a score of 8 for ride presentation. Ride intensity. If you've ridden one SLC, you've basically ridden them all. Riddler Revenge is a standard SLC, so it doesn't feature the additional helix at the end of the ride like some do. Even though the coaster model is quite common, it doesn't mean that the ride isn't intense. There are moments of this ride that really pack a punch, especially the transition from the first drop into the rollover inversion. Riddler Revenge is an action-packed experience that keeps you moving from inversion to inversion. There are a total of 5 inversions. My personal favorite moment of the ride is the double inline twist. You are being spun around upside down, all while dodging many of the ride supports. It's one of the better foot chopper moments on any roller coaster. Regardless of what you think of your standard SLC, you have to admit that they can be intense, especially if you're riding in the last row. I'm giving Riddler Revenge a score of 8 for ride intensity. Fun factor. The reason why SLCs are widely hated in the coaster community is because of the headbanging. Fortunately, Riddler Revenge features the new vest restraints, so there is no more headbanging. Well, sort of, but I'll talk about that soon. If you can handle some of the ride's roughness, I think there is something here to enjoy. The inversions are fun, especially how fast the transitions are. There are plenty of foot chopper moments, so that should keep you well engaged. I found myself laughing during a good portion of this ride, mostly because of how it tosses you around in your seat. The ride might be rather rough, even with the vest restraints, but it's that feature that gives this coaster some charm. I felt like someone was trying to beat me up, but they were failing miserably. Riddler Revenge gets a score of 7 for the fun factor. Originality. This is the one category that is really going to hurt the ride's overall score. Beyond the vest restraints, which even those are original, the ride is completely unoriginal. The layout has been copied over 20 times, and that's not even including the other clone versions that feature very slight iterations. As I said earlier, if you've ridden one SLC, you've ridden them all. I'm giving Riddler Revenge a score of 1 for originality. The 1 point is only because the ride features the vest restraints. Ride smoothness. Before the vest restraints, an SLC coaster would be headbanging you to death. Well, maybe not that bad, but it depends on what row you are riding in. The farther you sit to the back of the train, the more intense the ride roughness can get. Because Riddler Revenge features the vest restraints, the headbanging has been eliminated. Well, except when the train is jackhammering you. If you are sitting near the front or the back, the ride will start to bang you back and forth during the transitions in and out of the couple of the inversions. It feels like the train is trying to eject you from the ride. Because this coaster didn't give me a headache, I really didn't mind some of the ride roughness. I kind of thought it was hilarious and kind of adds to the whole experience. I'm giving Riddler a score of 6 for ride smoothness. Okay, the final score comes to 6, which is closer to my average rating. Riddler Revenge isn't anything new, so thus its lower score. Unfortunately, these ride models can be quite rough, but the vest restraints really do improve the ride. Riddler has a nice paint job, so at least the ride looks well. The problem with this coaster is I really don't see a reason to re-ride it. If you're at Six Flags New England, just go ride Wicked Cyclone or Superman the Ride instead. If you don't feel like walking to the other side of the park, Batman the Dark Knight is right there, and that's a better coaster than this. If you've never ridden an SLC before, it's not going to hurt to give this coaster a spin, but just know it's basically a one and done. My personal score is going to be a 5. The ride lands right in the middle for me. I think it's one of the better looking SLCs out there, and it's also one of the more comfortable SLCs to ride, but it's still the same thing. I see no reason wasting my time riding this coaster again, unless I'm at the park with someone who hasn't ridden this thing and wants to ride it. Sure, I'll ride it with him, but beyond that, Riddler is retired in my eyes. Well, thank you for watching my review of Riddler Revenge. Let me know what you think of this Vekoma SLC in the comments below. Make sure to like this video and hit that subscribe button, that way you won't miss out on more great content coming your way by X Scream Thrills.